Good afternoon, guys. Today I'm going to talk about exercise number 2, displacement and dead weight. So let's start, guys. This is exercise number 2, displacement and dead weight. So we have here a problem, exercise 2.1, exercise 2.2, and 2.3. So all these exercises, I put it in an Excel, okay? So this is how he looks like. I'll just make this a little bit bigger. And here, exercise 2.1, and the problem says a light ship, ship's light displacement is 1771 metric tons, meaning this is the what you call the light ship or light displacement or light ship. All the weights on board were accounted as follows: ballast 1658, fresh water is 76 metric tons. Fuel oil is 206 metric tons. Diesel oil is 41 metric tons. As constant is 48 metric tons. Determine the ship's present dead weight and displacement. So these are the following weights. Okay, ballast 1658. This one. Fresh water 76, and fuel oil 206. And diesel oil is 41 and constant is 48. So you add all these weights, this is what we call dead weight. So dead weight is 2029. So this is the dead weight, or what we call sometimes the cargo weight or ROV. Now to find the displacement is your light ship, which is 1771, plus your dead weight or this non-cargo weight. You add this one and you will get 3,800. So this will be your displacement, okay? So you add this one. So to find the displacement, I have here a displacement here. So your dead weight plus your light ship is your displacement. So to get the dead weight, your cargo weight plus your non-cargo weight or ROV is your dead weight plus your light ship is your displacement. So this is what we get from so light ship plus dead weight, so we have the displacement. Okay, so we go to exercise 2.2. okay, 2.2 says here, a light displacement or light ship is 1771 metric tons. She's loaded of 5,105 metric tons of cargo. After loading, accounting other weights on board are as follows: fresh water, including drinking water, is 152 metric tons. Fuel oil is 412 metric tons, and diesel oil is 82 metric tons. Constant is 49 metric tons. Determine the ship's dead weight and displacement. So it's also asking the dead weight and displacement. Okay, so we go here. This is number 2. Okay, so you have here the light displacement or light ship, which is 1771. And you have this the cargo of 5,108, and you have the fresh water together with drinking water is 152, which is this one, and fuel oil is 412, diesel oil is 82, and constant is 48. A total of 5,802. Look at here, guys, the cargo plus the non-cargo weight is your dead weight. So check this one. So your cargo weight plus your non-cargo weight is your dead weight, okay? So your cargo or your cargo of the vessel plus your non-cargo weight or ROV, that will be your dead weight, okay? So you go back. So you have this light displacement is 1,771 plus your dead weight, which is this one, plus your cargo, is 5,802. You add this one, that should be your displacement of 7,573, okay? Then we go to exercise 2.3, okay? So exercise 2.3 says a ship summer displacement, meaning the summer load line of summer drop or displacement is 7,573. Your lightship is 1,701.71 metric tons. The ship has the following weights already on board. Fresh water 118, fuel oil is 376, diesel oil is 68, and constant is 48. Determine how much cargo must be loaded so as not to exceed the summer displacement. Okay, so how much is asking for the allowable loadable cargo? Okay, so we go here. This is number 3. So you have this the lightship of 771. You have your ballast 0, your fresh water of 118 here, your fuel oil of 376, which is 376 here, and diesel oil is 68. You have your diesel oil is 68, this one, and constant is 48. And your total dead weight is 610, or what we call the non-cargo weight or ROV. So your summer displacement is 7573 metric tons, which is this one, minus your lightship will be lightship of 1771. Your dead weight would be 5,802. So meaning displacement minus lightship. Displacement minus lightship is your dead weight, okay? Then, So this will be your dead weight minus your non-cargo weight of 6,110, which is this one, minus your non-cargo weight will be your cargo weight, okay? So your dead weight minus your non-cargo weight of 610, that will be your cargo to load. This will be your allowable cargo to load, okay? Or maximum cargo to load. So that's it, guys. I hope you like this video. This is only a simple or basic computation of dead weight, displacement, and how to get the lowable cargo to load, okay? So that's it, guys. If you like this video, please click the like button, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to click the notification bell. Thank you for watching, and have a good day.